Now that we know what fractional exponents are, let's tackle a few computations involving these fractional exponents. We'll start with 16 to the 3 halves. Well, now we know that those exponent rules, those really handy exponent rules, they work with fractional exponents as well. 16 is 4 squared, so if we write 16 as 4 squared, we can break out our power of a power exponent rule to compute this as 4 raised to the 2 times 3 halves. Power. Power over power means we multiply the exponents. 2 times 3 halves is 4 cubed. 4 cubed is 4 times 4 times 4. 4 times 4 is 16. 16 times 4 is 64. And we're on to the next problem. Now we have 2 fractional exponents to deal with. All right, I'm doing one at a time. 9 to the 2 thirds. Well, 9 is 3 squared. We can use our power of a power again. And we have 3 squared to the 2 thirds, and that gives me, multiply the exponents, 3 to the 2 times 2 thirds is 3 to the 4, that didn't help. I mean, this came out to a nice number, nice whole number. This is not a nice whole number. Well, I guess a few things to learn here. First of all, they don't always come out to nice whole numbers. You know, 9 to the 2 thirds is not a whole number. Second thing to learn here is, when you're stuck, don't be afraid to start over. This doesn't seem to be helping us. So I'm going to go back and look at the original problem and see if there's anything I missed. The bases are the same. The bases are the same here, so we have an exponent rule for when the bases are the same. When the bases are the same, we're multiplying these two numbers, we add the exponents. That works for fractional exponents as well. And that gives us 9 to the 2 thirds plus 5 sixths. And 2 thirds, well, that's 4 sixths. 4 sixths plus 5 sixths is 9 sixths. Which is 3 halves. Aha! Now we can use that power of a power rule. We can write this as 3 squared raised to the 3 halves power. 2 times 3 halves is 3, so this is 3 cubed, which is 27. So while each one of these alone is not a nice whole number, their product is. Whew. All right. On to the last problem. Another 27. Well, this time we have a negative exponent. Well, we know how to handle negative exponents. If we have something like a to the minus n and a isn't 0, we can write this as 1 over a to the n. We're going to do the same thing here. That'll at least take care of the negative exponent. 27 to the negative 2 thirds is just 1 over 27 to the 2 thirds. And now we can use that exponent power of a power rule. So 27 is 3 cubed. And we're raising that to the 2 thirds power. So that's just 3 times 2 thirds is 2. So this is just 1 over 3 squared, which is 1 ninth. And we're done.